Welcome dear students, today we are going to deal with our 7th chapter of Flamingo book, which has been titled as The Interview. This has been authored by Christopher Sylvester, who is a London-based journalist. Christopher Sylvester was born in 1959. He was a history student and later he started working for a famous magazine. The name of the magazine is Private Eye. He served this magazine almost for 10 years as a reporter. And the chapter which we are going to read is an excerpt, a piece of writing from his introduction to the Penguin Book of Interviews, which is an anthology from 1859 to the present day. Dear students, if I ask you what is interview, I am sure most of you can define it, because either you have been interviewed or you have read about an interview at some point of your life. So, what is interview? Interview is a face-to-face discussion, okay, where two people or more than two person discuss about the common points, common issues, common agendas. One asks the questions, who is known as interviewer, and the another one is expected to reply those questions, who is interviewee. The interviewee expresses his opinions, his views about the questions or the issue discussed by the interviewer. So, this interview came into existence almost 130 years back, and till that day it came into existence. From that day and till the present day, there have been various changes in this, means the method of conducting an interview, the way of asking questions, the agenda points which are to be discussed have been varied according to the time. Means interview लेने का तरीका, इस पर जो points discuss किए जाते हैं वो, और इसके जो method हैं वो vary किए हैं, means उनमें changes आए हैं according to time. Till date thousands of celebrities have undergone interview, they have been interviewed and they have different opinions about the interviews. So this chapter is divided in two parts. That is, the first part deals with the different opinions about interview of different celebrities, various people, intellectuals, academicians. Someone says that it is not good at all. They say that they have described about the advantage and disadvantage of the interview, whether it should be taken or not, whether somebody should be interviewed or not. So, they have different opinions, different viewpoints about the interview. Someone says it is an unwarranted intrusion, means an unauthorized interference in somebody's life. Somebody says it is horrific event or incident in somebody's life. Someone says this is a breach of privacy, means the interviewer asks the private questions and the interviewee is forced to reveal about his privacy, means his privacy is marred, his privacy is disclosed. So this is an intrusion. Someone says that this interview is an ordeal, a bad experience. But after all, they have come to a conclusion that despite its many disadvantages, interview brings before us many of the opinions or views of the celebrities, famous personalities within no time. So we get an opportunity by means of interview to know about the various personalities, their lifestyle, the reason behind their success, the purpose behind their commitments. So in other way, interview is being considered as a big media, okay, to know about the celebrities. The second part deals with an interview which goes on between two person. That is, one is Umberto Eco, a famous novelist, an academician, essayist, who belongs to Bologna, Italy, and he is interviewee, and the person who takes interview is Mukund Padmanabhan, who is an interviewer and editor of the Hindu newspaper. In this second part, Mukund Padmanabhan questions Umberto Eco about his success as a novelist. He asked him, what are the characteristics of your life that make you such a successful person as a novelist? So he says he wants himself to be known as an academician rather than a novelist. Though he has been famous about as a novelist, but he still wants himself to be recognized, to be identified as an academician, because he loves academics. He has been associated with academics teaching for almost 50 years. Still, he switched on to fictional life, that is writing the novels. And the reason behind it, that he got the success in his life as a novelist, is that he makes use of the free time. As in an atom, there is a free space, because as a science student you can understand, there in an atom a free space lies which can be utilized. So in our life also there is some free space, free time, which he describes as intrinsics. And if we start using those that time, those free spaces, we can write the novels in that. We can write some fictions in that free time. Umberto Eco uses his free time in writing fictions. Yes, one more point he added is that he never attends any clubs, okay, any pen clubs. Rather, he spends his time, quality time, with the academicians or in attending the academic conferences. Second one is, he says that the interviewer asked him that he has written a novel. The name of the novel is The Name of Rose, and which was sold in almost 10 to 15 million copies. So he asked the reason behind its huge success of this novel. The title of the novel was The Name of the Rose. And there was a difficult language and stuff was used in this novel by Umberto Eco. So Umberto Eco says, this is the journalism, the journalist, the interviewers who say that people like the trash, means bad material. उनका मानना है कि लोग खराब जो मटेरियल उसको लाइक करते हैं. बट व्हाट आई हैव एक्सपीरियंस इज दैट 10 to 15% पॉपुलेशन ऑफ द टोटल पॉपुलेशन लाइक द डिफिकल्ट लैंग्वेज. ओके, दे लाइक द डिफिकल्ट लैंग्वेज ऑफ द नॉवल्स. एंड दे वांट टू एक्सपीरियंस द डिफरेंट थिंग्स इन देयर लाइफ. सो my novel has been read by this population, 10 to 15%, and which has risen to a huge number. This is the reason. Yes, when Padmanabhan asks him, is it the reason that you have discussed about or you have touched the medieval history in your novel, he says that maybe the discussion about medieval history the reason of success of this novel. But yes, timing also matters. Had I published this novel 10 years ago, or would have planned to publish this novel 10 years later, maybe this much success it wouldn't have recorded. Okay, so timing also matters. Timing of publication of an issue of a novel or whatever piece of writing is there. So the timing was also the matter behind its success. So dear students, this was the introductory part of this chapter. Let me cover up the textual part so that you can understand it in a better way. Thank you. Let's deal with the textual part. Since its invention a little over 130 years ago, the interview has become a commonplace of journalism. So dear students, interview came into existence 130 years ago. In our life, in journalism mainly, and since then it has become an essential part of journalism. Means you can say that without interview journalism is incomplete. Today almost everybody who is literate will have read an interview at some point in their lives. Means whoever is educated today, he either must have read about an interview in newspaper, magazine or in any other media, or he or she has been interviewed at some point of his or her life. While from the other point of view, several thousand celebrities have been interviewed over the years, some of them repeatedly. Yes, there are thousands of celebrities, famous personalities in this world who have been interviewed in last 130 years. Yes, there are some people out of them who have been interviewed repeatedly, means number of times they have been interviewed, not only once, they have been interviewed number of times. So it is hardly surprising that opinions of the interview, of its functions, merits, methods vary considerably. Yes, if these many people have been interviewed so far, then obviously the opinions about the interview will be in thousands. That is, what are the drawbacks, what are the advantages, disadvantages, methods of conducting interview, its merits, its functions. The opinions, the views about these characteristics of interview are varying, are changing considerably. Okay, जब इतने सारे लोगों का इंटरव्यू हो तो सभी के ओपिनियन उसके बारे में अलग अलग होगी, इसके फंक्शंस के बारे में, मेथड्स के बारे में और मेरिट्स के बारे में. इट इज़ ऑब्वियस. सम माइट मेक क्वाइट एक्स्ट्रावेगेंट क्लेम्स फॉर इट एज बीइंग इन इट्स हाईएस्ट फॉर्म ए सोर्स ऑफ ट्रूथ एंड इन इट्स प्रैक्टिस एन आर्ट. यस, सम पीपल कंसिडर इट एज एन आर्ट ऑफ एक्सट्रैक्टिंग ट्रूथ फ्रॉम पीपल. सो दिस इज द बेस्ट मीडिया ऑफ एक्सट्रैक्टिंग ट्रूथ, सीक्रेट्स ऑफ somebody's लाइफ. कुछ लोग इसको अच्छे मानते हैं. अदर्स यूजली सेलिब्रिटीज हु सी themselves एज इट्स विक्टिम्स. देर आर द सेलिब्रिटीज ऑन द अदर हैंड हु फाइंड themselves एज द फॉलन विक्टिम्स टू द इंटरव्यूअर. दे आर बींग विक्टिमाइज, इट इज देयर ओपिनियन. माइट डिस्पाइज द इंटरव्यू एज एन अनवारंटेड इंट्रूजन इन टू देयर लाइव. They consider interview as an unauthorized intervention into their privacy, in their private life. So they dislike it, okay? Or feel that it somehow diminishes them. Just as in some primitive cultures, it is believed that if one takes a photograph portrait of somebody, then one is stealing that person's soul. Yes, those celebrities think that this interview has diminished them, this interview has tarnished their either image or their life, their career. Bahut sare logon ka career isse kharab khatam ho jata hai, because the interviewer asks different questions, and in some of the questions while replying, either due to slip of tongue or due to their aggression or frustration, disappointment, the interviewee give some indifferent replies which are not liked by the common people, so that affects their career. Then the celebrity says that it is just like stealing somebody's soul by taking his photograph or portrait, which happened in earlier times, earlier history. Okay, इन एंशियंट टाइम्स जब भी किसी की फोटोग्राफ या उसका पोर्ट्रेट बना देते थे तो ऐसा लगता था कि उसको सोल को चुरा लिया गया है. दे डिसलाइक्ड इट. सो इन टुडे जरा इंटरव्यू इज कंपेयर्ड विद दैट काइंड ऑफ एक्शन. वी एस नॉयपोल फील्स दैट सम पीपल आर वॉन्डेड बाई इंटरव्यूज एंड लूज ए पार्ट ऑफ देम सेल्स. वी एस नॉयपोल, ए फेमस लिटरेरी पर्सन, ए कॉस्मोपोलिटन राइटर, हैज एक्सप्रेस्ड हिज views about interviews. He says that by getting interviewed, the interviewee is being wounded, he is being hurt, and by doing so he has to lose a part of himself, his privacy, his own life. Lewis Carroll on the other hand says that the creator of Alice in Wonderland is a series of movies, okay, and which mainly is about children, the children movies, for it is for their interest, was said to have had a just horror of the interviewer. Yes, Lewis Carroll described about an event when he was interviewed, and he said that it was not less than a horror, a horrific incident in his life, and thereafter he never consented, never agreed to be interviewed thereafter, because it was a horrific experience of his life. It was his horror of being lionized. Lionized means to treat somebody as a celebrity. An interviewer treats a person as a celebrity, and he asks him questions according to his rank, his career, which made him thus repel would-be acquaintances, interviews, and the persistent petitioners for his autograph, and he would afterward relate the stories of his success in silencing all such people with much satisfaction and amusement. So they would treat him as a celebrity, which forced him to repel these acquaintances, means jo known people the unko like kar unko chahte the ki wo dur rahe usse, interviewers ko, and the persistent petitioners who continuously appeal somebody for his photograph. So inko chahte the ki wo usse dur rahe, and he would afterwards relate the stories, and afterwards jo unko apne personal life ke bare mein ya zyada na bata ke, wo unko apni jo stories hain, unki success stories hain, उनके बारे में वो डिस्कस करते, और वो इंटरव्यूअर्स को चुप करते, उनका मुंह बंद करते, और इसी में वो सेटिस्फेक्शन और एम्यूजमेंट फील करते थे. लेविस कैरोल. रुडयार्ड किपलिंग एक्सप्रेस्ड एन इवन मोर कंडेमनेटरी एटीट्यूड टुवर्ड्स द इंटरव्यूअर. यस, रुडयार्ड किपलिंग हु इज़ द राइटर ऑफ द जंगल बुक, ही हैज़ एक्सप्रेस्ड हिज व्यूज ओपिनियन अबाउट इंटरव्यू. He considered interview as a condemnatory thing, means he has expressed his strong disapproval for the interview. And one day when he was interviewed, his wife penned down the incident in her diary. His wife Caroline writes in her diary for 14 October 1892 that their day was wrecked means attacked or ruined by two reporters from Boston. So when Rudyard Kipling was interviewed by two reporters from Boston on 14th October 1892, she recorded whole incident in a diary. She says that their day was destroyed by these two reporters. How? She reports her husband as saying to the reporters, Why do I refuse to be interviewed? So डायरी में उन्होंने लिखा है कि मेरे हस्बैंड उनसे बोल रहे हैं इंटरव्यूअर से कि why should I refuse to be interviewed? मैं इंटरव्यू देने से क्यों मना करता हूँ? Because it is immoral. इंटरव्यू एक इमोरल एक्टिविटी है. It is a crime. Okay, he has said it a crime. Just as much as of a crime as an offense against my person, as an assault, and just as much merits punishment. So it is just like a crime, as offense against my person, means it is a kind of offensive activity to steal my personal secrets, it is an intervention in my personal life, it is a sneaking in my personal life, okay. So it is an assault, it is an attack on my personal life, and just merits punishment. So jaise ek क्रिमिनल को क्राइम करने के लिए जो पनिशमेंट मिलता है, उतना ही पनिशमेंट इस इंटरव्यू के लिए बनता है, इंटरव्यूअर के लिए. ओके, क्योंकि इंटरव्यूअर भी एक प्रकार का क्राइम ही कर रहा है बाय टेकिंग द इंटरव्यूज ऑफ ए पर्सन. इट इज कवार्डली एंड वाइल, मींस दिस इज ए कवार्डिस एक्ट, दिस इज ए कवार्डिस एक्ट, एंड मींस नॉट एन एक्ट ऑफ ए डेयरिंग पर्सन. एंड वाइल मींस an extremely unpleasant activity. No one seeks any happiness in getting interviewed or being interviewed by somebody. Kisi ko khushi nahi milti interview dene mein. No respectable man would like it, much less give it. Means koi bhi respectable person hai wo interview dena pasand nahi karega. Yet Kipling had himself perpetrated such an assault on Mark Twain only a few years before. So perpetrate means commit. कमिटेड टू डू समथिंग। तो कहता है ये सब होने के बाद भी किपलिंग ने कुछ सालों पहले एचजी वेल्स के ऊपर ये जो है कमिटमेंट किया था, इस तरह का अटैक किया था मार्क ट्वाइन पे, नॉट एचजी वेल्स पे, मार्क ट्वाइन पे। इट मीन्स रुडयार्ड किपलिंग ने भी मार्क ट्वाइन का एक इंटरव्यू लिया था। एचजी वेल्स इन एन इंटरव्यू इन 1894 रेफर्ड टू द इंटरव्यूइंग ऑडियल। सो एचजी वेल्स इज अनदर पर्सन हु वाज बीइंग इंटरव्यूड एट सेवरल ओकेजंस एंड ही ऑल्सो इंटरव्यूड ए पर्सन, वी विल डिस्कस इट अबाउट इट लेटर, बट लेट मी टेल दैट इन 1894 एच जी वेल्स सेड दैट इंटरव्यू इज एन ऑडियल, इट इज़ अ बैड एक्सपीरियंस, एंड एच जी वेल्स वॉज द राइटर ऑफ द इनविंसिबल मैन, ए नावल विच यू हैव ऑलरेडी रेड इन योर प्रीवियस स्टैंडर्ड, बट वॉज ए फेयरली फ्रिक्वेंट इंटरव्यू वी एंड 40 ईयर्स लेटर। यस, कहते हैं एच जी वेल्स इसको एक बुरा एक्सपीरियंस मानता था, फिर भी वो 40 ईयर्स तक लगातार इंटरव्यू उनका होता रहा, स्टिल फाउंड हिमसेल्फ इंटरव्यूइंग जोसेफ स्टालिन, और उसके बाद भी उन्होंने जोसेफ स्टालिन का इंटरव्यू भी लिया। मीन्स ये लोग इसको बुरा भी मानते थे, अच्छा नहीं मानते थे, स्टिल इट वॉज एन एसेंशियल पार्ट ऑफ देयर लाइफ, यू कैन से इन अनदर वे, बिकॉज ऑलमोस्ट ऑल ऑफ देम हैड बीन इंटरव्यूड आइदर वंस और रिपीटेडली। जोसेफ स्टालिन, सोल बेलो हु हैज़ कंसेंटेड टू बी इंटरव्यूड ऑन सेवरल ओकेजन्स नेवर दी लेस वंस डिस्क्राइब्ड इंटरव्यूज एज बींग लाइक थंब प्रिंट्स ऑन इज विंड पाइप। यस, देर इज वन मोर पर्सन, सोल बेलो हु वॉज इंटरव्यूड सो मेनी टाइम्स बाई हिज ओन एग्रीमेंट, ओके, बाई हिज ओन एग्रीमेंट ही वॉज बींग इंटरव्यूड एट वेरियस ओकेजन्स। इन स्पाइट ऑफ दैट ही सेड दैट इंटरव्यू इज लाइक ए थंब प्रिंट ऑन विंड पाइप मीन्स इट कॉजिज सफोकेशन, इट चोक्स द पर्सन्स विंड ट्रैक्ट, रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट, घुटन महसूस होती है, ऐसा इंटरव्यू का एक्सपीरियंस उन्होंने बताया। ठीक है, इतने बार इंटरव्यू देने के बाद भी वो इंटरव्यू के बारे में बोलते हैं कि ये किसी के भी गला घोंटने के बराबर है, मीन्स सफोकेशन फील होता है, इसे दम घुटता है अगर इंटरव्यू देता है तब आदमी। यट डिस्पाइट द ड्रॉबैक्स ऑफ द इंटरव्यू इट इज़ ए सुप्रीमली सर्विसेबल मीडियम ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन, एंड ही सेज दैट डिस्पाइट इट्स डिमेरिट्स, इट्स ड्रॉबैक्स, इट्स डिसएडवांटेजेस, द इंटरव्यू इज द बेस्ट मीडियम ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन। मीन्स ड्यूरिंग इंटरव्यू वी कैन कम्युनिकेट अबाउट द पर्सनल व्यूज ओपिनियंस ऑफ समबडी, एंड देर आर थाउजेंड्स ऑफ मिलियंस ऑफ पीपल who read about that interview, about the opinions of that famous personality. These days, more than at any other time, our most vivid impressions of our contemporaries are through interviews. So, here the author says that nowadays, we come to know about, we get acquainted with the opinions of our contemporary people. Contemporary means of the same age. समसामयिक जो लोग होते हैं उनके जो व्यूज होते हैं उनके बारे में हमें पता चलता है इंटरव्यूज़ के थ्रू ही। डेनिस प्रेन हैज़ रिटन, ऑलमोस्ट एवरीथिंग ऑफ मोमेंट रीचेज अस थ्रू वन मैन आस्किंग क्वेश्चंस ऑफ अनदर। सो डेनिस प्रेन ने लिखा है कि एक आदमी इंटरव्यू लेता है और उसके थ्रू एक ही मोमेंट में हमारे पास वो सारी चीज़ें उस इंटरव्यू के बारे में पहुंच जाती है जिसका वो इंटरव्यू ले रहा है। ओके, सो इंटरव्यू जिस आदमी का इंटरव्यू लेता है उसके लाइफ के जो भी मोमेंट्स हैं, जो भी उसके अचीवमेंट्स हैं, जो भी उसके गोल्स हैं, एम्बिशंस हैं, सक्सेसेस हैं, वो सारे के सारे हमारे पास विद इन ए मोमेंट पहुँच जाती हैं। बिकॉज ऑफ दिस द इंटरव्यूअर होल्ड्स ए पोजिशन ऑफ अनप्रेसिडेंटेड पावर एंड इन्फ्लुएंस। अनप्रेसिडेंटेड मीन्स विच इज नॉट नोन इन एडवांस। सो इसी वजह से, ड्यू टू दिस रीजन ओनली, द इंटरव्यूअर होल्ड्स ए प्रोमिनेंट पोजिशन एंड पावर एंड इन्फ्लुएंस इन हिज लाइफ। मीन्स इंटरव्यूअर का अपना एक ओन इम्पोर्टेंस होती है इसमें, उसका अपना इन्फ्लुएंस होता है, उसकी अपनी पावर होती है। सो मीडिया पर्सन्स के बारे में आप जानते हैं, दे कैन आस्क एनीथिंग टू एनीबडी इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ हिज स्टेटस, रैंक, पोर्टफोलियो। This is all about for today's class. We will continue our part 2 in our next class, in which Mukund Padmanabhan takes interview of Umberto Eco. Thank you. Have a nice day.